remember at our last lecture, we took up the subject of how to keep awake. And on looking about me, I noticed that many of you did not seem quite to catch the idea. Today, therefore, we are taking up the subject of how to sleep. And I am hoping for a little better response. Now, in order to make the thing clearer to you, I will take up first the causes of sleep, second, methods of inducing sleep, third, methods of avoiding sleep, and fourth, how to wake up, which is very important. First, causes of sleep. Sleep is induced by the blood leaving the brain, thus. Or, as in the case of alcoholics, the brain leaving the blood. Now, there are several methods of drawing the blood sufficiently away from the brain to induce sleep. There is, for example, a hot pine bath before retiring. Sprinkle the salts in. Nothing like those old pine needles. Test the bath. Oh, a little too hot, I guess. Of course, there's always the alternative method of not taking the hot pine bath. In this case, the man has succeeded only in putting his left foot to sleep. But that's something. A little more each night, and he'll soon be cured of his insomnia. We now come to a study of those factors which send the blood to the brain, thereby making sleep impossible. You will notice that the patient is having a little trouble finding a place for his head. This is known as insomnia or chronic pillow inflation. Chief among the methods of keeping blood in the brain is worry. You can worry better sitting up. Worry can be caused by putting your mind on any one thing. No matter what it is, you'll find it easy enough to worry about it in the middle of the night. There's a theory that if you count imaginary sheep jumping over a fence, you'll induce sleep. This has been proven to be a fallacy, as the patient is likely to start worrying about one of the sheep not quite making it. They seem to be running all right now. One, two, three, three and a half, four, five, six. Oh, there they go. I know it. Now, another thing which keeps the blood in the brain and prevents sleep is noise. Any unaccustomed noise strikes the eardrums and stimulates circulation in the brain. The sound does not have to be a loud one to cause sleeplessness. A mosquito doing a spiral from a high altitude will do the trick. Here he comes. Now, wait just a minute, and then you can get him when he lights. Take it easy. Take it easy. Well, missed him. Well, try and bite through this, sugar. One of the main causes of sleeplessness, however, is bodily discomfort in the bed due to faulty bed making. This results in the peekaboo blanket and the side slip combined with the riding pajama top. You will note that the sleeper's back is entirely bare. Because here it is talking. We have here a pamphlet issued by the Mellon Institute in Pittsburgh showing photographs made of a man during an 8-hour sleep. It was found that he changed position 55 times, which is normal for the average healthy sleeper. Let us study these positions now in detail without actually getting into bed with the man. He dropped off in this position, which is called the supine curl, which he held for 3 minutes. Then into this, known as the kitten coil, which he held for 20 minutes, practically a record for the course. Then into this, or sleeping, sitting, standing, crouch, which held him for 11 minutes. The best way to get into this position is to fall into it from above. This is a great favorite with drunks. The advantage of this position is that it gets him so close to the bed. Here he decided for smothering himself, which he did for 8 minutes. And now into the ventrolateral sprawl, which amounts to doing a Highland fling in bed. He liked this so well that he goes into a more difficult step. In this position, he is ready to hop out of bed at a moment's notice. But now let's get back to the poor sleeper. He's dropped off for an hour or so, but pretty soon begins to feel that old thirst creeping up on him. An owl seems to have got into his mouth.
What's that? Just nerves, I guess.
And then over to figure out the best thing to do. He's running three courses over in his mind. To get up and get a drink, to lie there and die of thirst, or to go back to sleep. The last is out of the question. The second would take too long. Oh, he might as well get the drink of water. Now, the point is to walk into the bathroom and back without waking himself up completely.
Walk very carefully with the eyes half closed in order not to get the circulation started.
Who left that door open?
There we go. Now, that glass ought to be right about here. No. Pick that safety razor. There we are. Hold a little closer. Now, there's no water in that. There's no water in that. Oh, careful, careful. Now. Oh, don't spill it. There we go. Boy. Now, back to bed.
Look out for those shoes.
Whoop. Now he's good and wide awake. And he stays wide awake until just before it's time for the alarm clock to go off. Then sleep begins to creep up on him.
That goes. There he goes. Follow that. No sense in trying to go to sleep now. That clock's going to ring.
Well, I guess that'll be all for today.
Falling downstairs.
Dream. If I have to see that, you'll leave it.
He is about to enter a world that no one has ever seen before. The world of your dreams.
Everyone's got to dream, young lady. If you don't dream, you go. Okay, all set? Okay. She's asleep now.
What the hell are dreams, anyway?
Mysteries. Incredible body hocus pocus.
The truth is, we still don't know what they are or where they come from. Thank you.
going into deep sleep now. Heart rate is a little high. It's just due to anxiety. Otherwise, she's nicely relaxed. All signs are normal. She could dream at any time now. Beta waves are slowing. She's into REMs now. She's definitely dreaming now. It's a good one, too. Typical dream parameter. A nightmare now would be plus or minus 5 or 6. She's about 3.
Doctor, what's she doing now? Is she asleep or awake?
Seemed like I'd walked into an alternate universe.
Seems like everyone's sleepwalking through their waking state or wakewalking through their dreams.
Just wake up.
It's like I'm being prepared for something.
I am a passenger. And I ride.
You know, they say that dreams are real only as long as they last. Couldn't say the same thing about life. See, there's a lot of us that are out there that are mapping that mind-body relationship of dreams. We're called the oneironauts. We're the explorers of the dream world. So you have these serotonic neurons that inhibit hallucinations, that they themselves are inhibited during REM sleep. See, this allows dreams to appear real while preventing competition from other perceptual processes. This is why dreams are mistaken for reality. To the functional system of neural activity that creates our world, there is no difference between dreaming a perception and an action and actually the waking perception and action.
You create the world of the dream. We bring the subject into that dream, and they fill it with their subconscious.
How could I ever acquire enough detail to make them think that it's reality?
Well, dreams, they feel real while we're in them, right? It's only when we wake up that we realize something was actually strange. Let me ask you a question. You never really remember the beginning of a dream, do you? You always wind up right in the middle of what's going on.
I guess, yeah.
So how did we end up here?
Well, we just came from the,
Think about it, Ariadne. How did you get here? Where are you right now?
We're dreaming?
You're actually in the middle of the workshop right now, sleeping. This is your first lesson in shared dreaming. Stay calm.
Wake up, honey.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place.
Dorothy. Dorothy, dear. It's Aunt Em, darling.
Oh, Auntie Em. It's you.
Yes, darling.
Hello there. Anybody home? I just dropped by because I heard the little girl got caught in the big... Well, she seems all right now.
Yeah, she got quite a bump on the head. We kind of thought there for a minute she was going to leave us.
Oh.
But I did leave you, Uncle Henry. That's just the trouble. And I tried to get back for days and days.
There, lie quiet now. You just had a bad dream.